Everyone, meteorologist Matt Jones back in the Weather Center. Hey, we had a busy night. If you didn't join us for our live stream on WKBN or our Facebook page, as well as WKBN on Facebook, hey, we were just talking with a lot of viewers, and a lot of viewers sent in some photos. We see this in Austintown. It's that same shelf cloud that we saw earlier, kind of an ominous-looking cloud, and that's exactly what brought the rain. Now, also this picture, and I want to show this one because this was sent in by Chandler, and I thought, even though it's kind of grainy, this is really kind of fascinating. Not cool. Because this is actually lightning, and it blurred the entire image and was taken from a video. Now, this just goes to show you the effects of lightning and what it actually can do. So again, even though a lot of us didn't see that severe wind threat, a lot of us did see a lot of lightning, and a lot of us did see a lot of rain. So we're going to go ahead and check it out. We see that loop of that last couple of hours. Everybody got soaked throughout the valley. That's a given. But as far as severe winds, and we said for the last couple of days that there was the potential of severe weather this afternoon, and that was. Mercer County got the brunt of it, and we saw tons of reports the same time, just wind damage, trees down, and that threat is over. So the good news is, well, that we're seeing also cooler temperatures behind it. You see this clear air. Now, cooler air is also associated with drier air. So when we have this cold front, which is what pushed all these storms through our area earlier, well, that's what's bringing some cooler air and some cooler temperatures. That means the dew points for right now, we see it right around 65. Well, the good news is that's going to drop. Even the temperature is going to drop. You see temperatures, we're looking into the upper 60s. That potentially might be our high for tomorrow. That's kind of the cooler temperatures we're talking about. That I'll mention that in just a second. Future tracker, we are seeing those showers move out of the area. Now, I'm keeping a 30% chance for a light shower overnight. Nothing too major. We're just going to see the cloud cover into tomorrow morning. I think Future Tracker does it overdoes it a little bit with the rain tomorrow morning. We're going to be left with sunny skies tomorrow afternoon. It's going to be absolutely beautiful. And then after that, we're going to be left with clear skies. That's going to lead from our Monday all the way through the rest of the week until we get to about Wednesday. We'll see that on the 7-day forecast in just a second. Tonight, we're looking at temperatures getting down into the upper 50s. There's that 30% chance of rain we're talking about. And then tomorrow, I have a high right around 71, but the models have been trending even cooler than that. So there's a potential that we might not even get out of the 60s in some spots. Now, we're also looking at our 7-day forecast. Well, this is interesting because look at the temperatures. Last week, we talked about temperatures in the 80s and we could potentially hit the 90s. This week, we're talking about temperatures in the 70s and we might not even see temperatures in the 80s. So, dare I say it, fall might be here. The only chance of rain that we're actually seeing this week is come Wednesday. You're watching 27 First News.